got many names. You got multiple names.
Whoa!
Oh!
Right there, bro.
Oh well, you saying that?
I know.
You got many different groups and different names.
Hold on.
Judaism. You get Christianity. You get Muslims. Islam.
Okay, check it out, bro.
Soon now, yeah, Shiite. I know. Listen, bro. You got multiple names. Monotheism. Do you believe in monotheism?
Okay, go ahead.
Do you believe in monotheism?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, that's what I believe in.
Okay, but he ain't got
I don't care what his name is.
Well, you ought to care what his name is. Because if I call you, if your name Billy.
I don't need to call his name.
If I'm calling you Billy and your name ain't Billy, how you gonna answer?
No.
If your name ain't Billy and I'm calling you an asshole, How you gonna answer?
Listen,
how's he gonna answer?
When your mother
came. Okay, let me read. Get your Bible out. You got your Bible with
when
you.
When your mother came up to your mother and you was hurt, did you need to call her name?
This is Zechariah 14.
Did you need to call her name?
Read Zechariah 14.
Take care of you. Did you? I'm just making a point. Excuse me, I'm in touch.
Excuse me.
But did you need to call her name if you was
Zechariah
hurt?
Zechariah 14 and 9.
She saw you fall down and you got up. Did you need to call her name?
The Lord shall be king over all the earth.
Listen, read it loud, bro. Read it loud.
The Lord shall be king over all the earth. In the day shall there be one Lord, and his name one.
His name one. He said many names.
He got one name.
He has many titles.
He has many titles, but one name.
If you know him.
Brother, you ain't gonna learn nothing if you don't learn to listen and learn.
Now, you know what I'm saying? Now you making me listen.
How else am I gonna get you to learn?
No, you can't make.
Well, listen to this, brother.
You can't make nobody listen to nothing. That's
if you don't want to listen to the scriptures, then you might as well just keep on walking.
I've read the scriptures. I know the scriptures.
You know the scriptures, then you should have known this.
Who the Lord come for? Ask me who the Lord come for.
Proverbs 30 and who the Lord coming for if you know the scriptures? Who is the Lord coming for if you know the scriptures?
He came for people that was already saved.
Well, who gave the scriptures?
He didn't come for nobody that was already saved.
Ain't nobody saved.
So he coming for me.
Ain't nobody saved yet.
He coming for me.
Hold on. We dust our feet of many parts of this sorry ass city.
So let him go.
You know? I'm letting go with scriptures.
Abide in the fruits of
who have ascended up into
God? God? You ain't got to prove God.
Or descend.
Exactly.
Who have gathered the winds in his fists? Who have bound the waters in his garment? Listen. Who have established all the ends of the earth? What is his name? And what is his son's name? If thou canst tell.
I recognize that.
Israelites. He knows absolutely nothing. That's why you're about to run down the street. You know.
I never run that.
Where we gonna go with this, man?
I can't.
I got another one.
I don't argue about the scripture.
Acts 4:12.
What's in my heart? What's in my heart is what matters.
Listen,
it don't matter what you say, he say, Islam, Iraq, Shia, Sunnah,
in your heart.
All of that don't matter. It's what's in your heart that matters. You can preach all you want.
Are you absolutely sure about that?
You can say one word and turn somebody all the way around, have them twisted. I'm not twisted. I know what's in my heart and what's in my mind.
You have wicked thoughts in your heart.
I have wicked thoughts.
You don't even know me.
You tell me I got wicked thoughts in my
heart. You're saying it right now. You're
you don't even know me,
say
I got
right
wicked
now.
Thoughts in my heart.
You don't? You telling me you don't?
I'm far from perfect, but I don't have wicked thoughts.
Are you a man? Are you a man of the Lord?
You just judge me based upon what?
We're out here to judge.
Based upon what you said. You said I got wicked thoughts in my heart.
We're set up as watchmen out here.
You drop one of your knots.
That's hard, dude.
You said I have wicked thoughts in my heart. You don't even know.
You're Jeremiah 17 and 9.
You don't even know me, no.
Oh, I got it.
You can preach all the words you want.
This is Jeremiah 17 and 9.
But here's what you
got. The heart is deceitful above all things.
You can know the Bible.
Read that again.
This is Jeremiah 17 and 9.
You can know inside out, backwards.
The heart
breathe it and
is deceitful of all things.
Read that again, one more time.
And only one can judge me.
The heart is deceitful above all things.
Read it one more time.
If you don't believe in Jesus Christ.
And desperately wicked.
By Jesus Christ.
Now you said your heart.
You ain't going nowhere near heaven if you don't believe in his son. No, you said well, my heart was wicked.
What's his son's name?
Come
on with that boom, man. Come on, dude. Man, please, you give us somebody
what
to know.
What is his son's name?
Man, I'm 50 years old.
What's his name?
Matthew 15:19. I was raised from a baby, from the cradle to the grave, I'll be believing in Jesus Christ's name. Don't forget it.
That Jesus ain't his name.
Only by him, through him, you will make it to the paradise.
How old? You said you how old?
He said Jesus.
Only by him,
he said Jesus
him,
Christ.
Yeah, but he said he was how old?
Listen, by him, through him, if you ain't believing in that, you believing in some bullshit.
He ain't trying to hear what you're saying, because you can't teach
him
nothing.
No, you listen. I'm telling you,
you ain't teaching him shit.
All that are listening.
Here you go. This is Matthew 15:19.
If you ain't believing
for
in him,
for out of the heart proceedeth evil thoughts, murderers, adulterers, fornication.
And I'm all that. I'm all that. And you're all that, too. You're born a sinner. You're born a sinner. You're a die sinner. Man, yeah, you're a sinner, too. Are you a sinner? Are you a sinner?
Well, how am I sinning right now?
No, are you a sinner?
How am I sinning
even
right
though
now?
You're preaching the word, you're still a sinner. So you
right
can't
now?
Ostracize me or say
right
this or that or any. You can't. There's not a bone. If you,
where's your garment at?
If you, I don't. My garment is my heart, and my heart is.
There go that heart again.
There go that heart again.
Yeah.
Love
believing
that heart.
In the Lord, believing in Jesus Christ.
Out
only
of
by
the heart
him,
proceedeth the Lord, evil thoughts.
Thus said the Lord, by him, only by him, that
what's
I can
the Lord's
make
name?
It through. Why
what's
you
the
saying
Lord's,
that?
What's the Lord's name?
It ain't Jesus.
What's the Lord's name? What's
man,
the Lord's
I know
name?
All about it. Jesus, quote J and all this and this and that.
Huh?
Like, now,
what are you saying then?
You're talking crazy, man.
What are you
listen.
Saying then?
You tell him you judge.
Wait,
just,
man, first you said you was going to shut your stupid ass mouth because I'm the one out here teaching. But he's out here running his goddamn mouth the whole fucking time saying nothing. Saying nothing.
Yeah, but now he don't believe in the Lord.
Goddamn.
He don't believe in that Lord.
Goddamn him.
He believe in something else.
God's name. God's name is goddamn.
That ain't his name.
He's a goddamn bunch of fools.
What's the Lord's
first
name?
Of all, his name is not goddamn. You goddamn, you damn somebody. Goddamn this fool.
Amen. God,
how is that the Lord's name?
God bless you, man.
And I'm not even going to tell y'all the Lord's name because you're not worthy of the Lord's name.
God bless you. God bless you, man. I'm far from a fool.
I'll take your blessing.
God bless you, man.
I'll take your blessing.
What you're saying is,
I'll take your blessing.
God bless you. Continue what you're doing.
Be careful of these buses and guns.
Man, trust me.
Be careful of these cars.
But the police.
Yeah,
yeah, you look like you've been had a couple drinks. They're going to get your ass.
You look like you had a couple drinks. Look like you don't fucking couple horse, nigga.
I wish we had a couple horse now. I wish we had a couple horse now.
Suck your dick.
I wish we had a couple horse. I wish we had a couple horse.
Yeah.
I wish we had a couple horse. With a few drinks. With a few drinks. We're judging you, fool.
Get 2 Corinthians 2:15.
I was going to get to one of the apocryphals.
Oh, that's a good one.
Second Corinthians.
Yeah, 2:15. Hey, hold on, I got a scripture for you. I got a scripture for you. You don't know no scripture. That ain't no scripture.
The wicked fleeth, and no man pursueth. The wicked fleeth. The wicked fleeth. The wicked fleeth.
You judge. Your ass will be in the hell of me, or I will be.
I ain't devil. That's a. He's preaching
which
that.
One, which one you asking?
2:15.
2:15.
You say.
What you doing, devil?
He say you can't judge.
2:15.
Second, I am my fault. 1 Corinthians 2:15. Why I say second?
All right, devil, why don't you just come on back and chat?
We can't hear your ass.
We can't hear your stupid ass. 2 Corinthians 2:15. But he that is spiritual judges all things. Don't get hit, fool. Don't get hit, fool!
He said, wipe your ass with your robe.
Scoffers like a motherfucker, man.
See, they gotta run, man.
It's all right.
You know, the scriptures come out, they just have to run. Run.
All he does is just make the video more entertaining.
Right, right.
That's all he does, you know what I'm saying? Right. The brothers can laugh and learn at the same time, you know what I'm saying?
I love these clowns, man. I love cutting the shit out of them.
Because it's a lot easier to learn when you're having a good time laughing.
Right. At first, the fool was saying, you out here, brother. You the one. You out here to preach and teach, man. That you, I'm just going to be quiet. That's what he was saying at first.
He ain't never been quiet, not once.
The whole time. Ain't teaching shit. Ain't telling nobody shit. Don't know shit.
Man,
he
was
eating shit. He is a piece of shit.
He was drunk.
Yeah.
He was drunk as fuck. He was drunk and probably on some shit.
These niggas crazy, man. Let me finish reading that. This is second part.
Because, you know, a lot of times these fools, they get high and drunk on some shit, and they think they have prophets. Think they having visions and shit.
Get time in the joint, read the Bible 10, 15 times.
Yeah.
And think they know it, you know. Come out, think they're holy, man. Some wicked-ass homosexual pastor will probably baptize them. And they come up out of that nasty-ass water with, you know, thinking they're some holy man.
Or they watch some Jesus TV.
Mm-hmm.
Right, you know what I'm saying? They got a couple lines they learned from Rob Parsley.
These motherfuckers think they can get us riled up, man. All we do is just read the scriptures. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of the Most High, for they are foolishness unto him. Neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. Just like that old fool. Because he said that, he was, what, 50 years old? What did he say?
Man, something like that. Yeah, 40, 50, something.
And he calling us young men. I'm damn near his age, too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So he just professed that he was just an old fool.
Like, you can't put new wine in an old wine bag.
Right.
It should burst open and explode.
What's that one in Job? I think it's Job 9.
Oh, talking about the elder, how... Mm-hmm. It talks about, I know what you're talking about.
Old fools, man. I hate when they run. That shit pisses me off, man. Makes you want to pick up a giant brick and just throw it at them, man.
Shit, soon we're going to be able to do that.
Right, right.
They're going to get fucked up.
Oh, here it is. It's Job 12 and 20. He removeth away the speech of the trusty, and take away the understanding of the aged. And this motherfucker talking about, man, I'm old, I'm and he don't understand a motherfucking thing but his own foolishness. But his own goddamn, he lucky he gone, man. We would've just been giving that motherfucker a spiritual ass whooping with these scriptures, man. Cause that's pretty much what we would've done, just giving a spiritual ass whooping with these scriptures. And that's why he was leaving. He didn't know a goddamn scripture. He didn't know nothing about the goddamn scripture.
We talking about, it's all about what you believe in your heart.
People around here laughing because you can see the motherfucker was a drunk fool. A drunk goddamn fool.
He sounded like he's out of his goddamn mind. I just thought it was funny the whole time. He's a big joke.
Oh my goodness.
He looked like a stand-up comedian or some shit.
Right. Toothless bandit. Right now, here raping bitches, too. Yes. It's Ohio State, full of characters. Full of motherfuckers.
This is the rape capital of the city.
Right. I'm going to go to Isaiah.
More bitches get raped.
I'm going to read Isaiah 1 and start at 1. Start at 1.
You hear the saying, dumb as an ox. Shit, an ox is smart.
Yeah, right.
Isaiah 1.
Yeah. Start at 3.
You gotta belt it too. You can't read it all soft.
Huh?
You gotta read aloud.
Alright, the ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master's crib. But Israel doth not know. My people doth not consider.
You good, bro. Just read that shit with confidence.
Alright, read again?
Just start from the top.
Alright,
yeah.
The ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master's crib. But Israel doth not know, my people doth not understand.
That fool was obviously an Israelite, but you know, he wasn't part of the fold, obviously. The Lord ain't dealing with that fool.
Right, because he don't know his master. He kept talking about Jesus.
Jesus.
And then he said, I know about all that J stuff. If you know about all that J stuff, what the fuck you still talking about Jesus?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
We asked him like 20 times what was the Lord's name.
Mm-hmm.
And he didn't know. Talking about he knows everything already. But he don't know the Lord's name.
Right.
The most important thing to possibly know.
And that's right. And we didn't give it to him either. Well, somebody like that, you don't give the Lord's name. The Lord's name is valuable. It's not something you just throw around just like it's just some piece of candy. You know,
because you
like
know when it feels, because sometimes it don't feel right just to throw it, to force it out there. Mm-hmm. It's just, you know when you can give people the name.
Right. He, when you give him the name, he's going to reject it anyway.
And throw it right back. Forget yeah, it. Right. One ear, route the other.
That's right. That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
He don't give a damn.
And scripture says, cast not your pearls, you know, these wicked ass niggas. And that's exactly what they are, a bunch of wicked ass niggas. You got to read more than that.
Isaiah 3 and 4. Sinful nation and the people laden with iniquity, a seed.
Sinful nation.
A seed of evildoers, children that are corruptors. They have forsaken the Lord. They have provoked the Holy One of Israel unto anger.
So that dude right there provoked the Most High to anger. The Most High is angry at his ass. He's gonna get fucked up.
They are all
but he's already fucked up though.
Yeah, yeah.
He's already received half his damn punishment. Look at his ass.
Looks like a hot mess.
He's fucking cursed.
Looks like a hot mess out here talking that Jesus shit. This is his God. This is his God. Along with all these other people. This
oh,
is
that is
God.
His God right there.
This is his God. This is the image in his mind. He'd accept his pastor being a homosexual, coming in with his husband and everything. He'll still accept that man as a man of the Lord. That's a fool, man. That's a fool.
He eat bacon every morning, I guarantee it.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna grab this man. Our sinful nation and people. The people laden with iniquity, a seed of evildoers, children that are corruptors. They have forsaken the Lord. They have provoked the Holy One of Israel unto anger. They are all gone away backwards.
They are all gone backwards. That describes Jake in America, period. They are all gone backwards. They a seed of evildoers.
Right, right, right.
Every last one of these motherfuckers is backwards as hell, man. Like the Lord says, that a wicked and adulterous generation. Just a nation of adulterers, thieves, fucking swindlers, cutthroats.
Right, right.
I told you, Miles out had been out at that flea market trying to do some hustling out there to get a little money to eat. And everybody's out there cutting each other's throats, man.
Oh, man, I can imagine.
It's just everybody's trying to hustle everybody. No one's trying to. It's just some bunch of dirty bastards. Everybody trying to cheat you,
right,
sell
right.
you some broken shit. They know it's broken. It's just a bunch of dirty motherfuckers, man.
That's it.
And nobody got no kind of honor, no kind of.
That's Israel.
Yeah. That's no, they just all gone backwards, a bunch of faggots.
They're finding this wicked ass nigga scripture. That's Israel, man. It's frustrating sometimes dealing with Israel, man. And you can see why the Lord had his hair. By the age 32 years old, the man was completely gray. Everything was completely gray dealing with Israel. Because Israel, man, whew.
It's, yeah.
Your blood pressure rise dealing with these fools sometimes, man. You know?
Yeah, that's why you motherfuckers' hair turn gray a lot of times.
Yeah, yeah.
Especially husbands. Men especially that have a wicked adulterous wife, motherfuckers' hair turn gray by the age of 30. You know what I mean?
Right, 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 right.
Have a heart attack by 50 and drop dead.
Oh shit, let me just get this.
That's why the women always live longer than the man. Because these wicked ass bitches stress their ass to death.
Mm-hmm. The bitch has no care in her heart anyway.
Hell no. So she's like a reptilian.
Right.
To eat her own children. You know what I'm saying?
Right. This is 2 Ezra. Let me start at 1. Wait, show the 2 Ezra 1 and 5. Go thy way and show my people their sinful deeds and their children their wickedness.
That's what we're doing right now. Mm-hmm. People say, why you say that about them people? You ain't supposed to judge nobody. Well, the scripture right there just said we supposed to go show their people their wicked ways.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? So that's our job. That's just like Isaiah 58:1 that says, cry aloud and spare not.
Mm-hmm.
And show my people their transgressions.
That's right. Go thy way and show my people their sinful deeds and their children their wickedness which they have done against me, that they may tell their children's children.
Yeah, the children's children, because you got all these wicked-ass women. They raising up little evil monsters. You know what I'm saying? And then they have children. Then each generation of children get worse than the last generation.
Worse.
You know what I'm saying?
And I'm telling you, man, I remember thinking into my pay, man, back in the early 90s, that this society, man, it couldn't be, because I was looking, you know, niggas were sagging back then. And they, you know, their foolish behavior, man. I was looking at motherfuckers like, it can't get no worse than that. Oh, God, was I wrong?
Man, I drive down Main Street every day, every last motherfucker sagging.
Everybody.
Every last bitch got her titties out, smoking cigarettes. You know what I'm saying?
It's wild when you see a woman sagging. That's wild shit.
All you see that bald-headed bitches sagging.
Fat ass and old. Bitches be having bodies and sagging, man. This is wild shit, man.
Well, usually bitches be half butt naked, wearing some tight-ass pants. Their shirt looks like a bra. They got tattoos all up on their titties. Tattoos all up and down their neck and on their face.
Got the tramp stamp in the back.
Yeah, they got tramp stamps. Man, so these motherfuckers out here ain't shit, man.
So we ain't gonna wake none of these people up. We only out here to mark the shit out of them.
Cause these people ain't shit, man.
Yeah, they ain't
shit. They worse than shit.
The dude getting on the bus talking about how you speaking the Lord's name, God, and saying God damn.
Like God is God's name. What kind of, that don't even make no damn sense.
Right. It's just proof they don't know what the fuck they talking about. Because the sins of their fathers are increased in them. For they have forgotten me and have offered unto strange gods.
A strange God? Have Muhammad's a strange God.
That's a strange God too.
Yeah, that's a strange God.
Yeah, Muhammad's definitely a strange God.
That's a weirdo.
Yeah. She was an Israelite.
Oh yeah, she probably was.
You know, she was an Israelite.
I mean, fuck it, at least she got her shit covered up. She looks a little weird, but
right.
Goddamn Muslims. But you Muslims, you ain't shit either, man.
Right, and this ain't for y'all either.
Hell no.
You're a Hamite. You're a Hamite.
Watch out, back up, dude. Back up.
Aren't you, where you from?
Yeah, goddamn Hamites, they can't even talk to you. You can't converse with them.
Right.
Or conversate with them.
Right.
Because they're fucking retarded. What's up, homie? Jake is bugged out of his fucking brains, man. He's just gone. He's in outer space. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
In fucking outer space.
Fucking gone.
Gone.
I mean, ain't nothing wrong with riding a skateboard, right? Get where you're going. It's a good form of exercise, but unfortunately, these people riding these skateboards are just they identify being a weirdo with riding skateboards.
Yeah, that's,
you know,
it's all about just doing weird shit and being a weirdo. And
some bumped out shit, man. That is right there. It's a Chinese dude too. Because the sins of their fathers are increased in them. For they have forgotten me and have offered unto strange gods. Am not I even he? Am not I even he that brought them out of the land of Egypt?
Out of Egypt? See, America is spiritually known as Egypt. You know what I'm saying? It's the new Egypt. Go ahead.
From the house of bondage? But they have provoked me unto wrath and despised my counsel.
Yeah, because even back in the ancient world, here it is, the Most High showed Israel all kind of wonders. Split the damn Red Sea, killed the Pharaoh, drowned his whole damn army.
They witnessed this.
And still, they wanted to act like some fucking heathens, man. Right. Be all ungrateful and shit.
Right, it ain't like us. Because he ain't, you know, he showed us a few things. But back then, he actually appears... chariots in front of them. You know? Now come on, you walking across the dirty ass side of the river. What's that called back there? Yep. And it just opens up and the Lord. You
the Olentangy.
You know what I mean? The Olentangy. Man, that'll bug you out, man. And they knew it was the Lord because he had a giant UFO out there that opened it up for him, you know? Back then, he actually was showing them, man, the angels was appearing in front of them. And they would drop. They would drop thinking they were going to get killed. Because the look of those angels was terrifying. You know,
plus, back then, Israel was real powerful.
Right.
And with all that power comes pride.
Woo! I'm telling you. Big Mo's got a question. What's up? You got a question?
What does this mean?
What's it mean?
Yeah. Well,
something about the Israelites. The Israelites of the Bible. Those people over in Israel right now, they're not the real Israelites. They're identity thieves. they stolen the so-called Negroes. The Negroes here in America, so-called people of Negro and Indian descent, they're the real Jews of the Bible. Okay, those people over here aren't the real Jews, and this is what we out here. We only out here, not for everybody, we only out here for the elect, and that's it, you know? That's it. We're out here pushing the truth. We're out here pushing the end of America, because this is the end of this country. It's about to be destroyed by thermonuclear missile. And that's in the Bible.
Where are we going to go?
Where are you going to go? Get burnt up by missiles.
Yeah, that's straight to hell.
Most of you heathens that are of the other nations get burnt up by missile, by thermonuclear missile.
That's what you call hellfire.
They're coming from all the other nations. Don't Russia got thousands of nukes?
So they're going to destroy America?
Right, right. Let me show you something.
So why are you listening?
You believe in the Bible. You read the Bible.
Yeah, I guess.
You guess. You guess you read?
I'm not that religious, but...
You're not that religious. We're not religious either. This is not a religious thing. This is all about truth. This is truth. Let me show you something. Get Malachi 4:1.
Oh yeah, that's a good scripture. Hey, you hold the camera, let me get Malachi.
Wait, what's the camera for?
Edifying people on the internet. This is for people that can't get out here. They have the internet, so they can learn on the internet. YouTube.
So witness to this.
That's how we were born.
All right, you can stand right there. You can stand right there.
The
Lord said he's gonna come like a thief in the night.
That's right.
Are you guys
calling? Oh, hell no.
No, it's actually no
more. That's very bad for your health. You have a heart attack, make you fat. You know, it makes you smell bad. Listen to this.
I'm not Jewish.
Matthew 24:36.
Like,
but that day and hour knoweth no man. Now, in this Bible, it gives you
clue. You probably have no clue what I'm talking about.
Hey, bro, if you want to listen, I'll come
He's
over
not
here.
Gonna give you
he don't want
to
be on there.
Yeah, one speaker at a time.
That's why the Bible says to watch and observe. So you'll know when, you know, it's that time is near.
Yeah.
Now, but of that day, an hour, no man, no. Not the angels of heaven, but only the Father. That's the only one who knows, the Heavenly Father. The angels, the Lord, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus, he don't even know. Now, but that missile.
Oh yeah, Malachi 4:1, for behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven.
Here it says, behold, the day cometh that will burn as an oven.
And all the proud, yea, and all that do wickedly shall be stubble.
That's all these people.
And the day that cometh shall burn them up, saith the Lord of hosts, that it shall leave them neither root nor branch.
Now we ask ourselves, what in the world that can just burn things up like that, you know? That can burn the elements. Let me get that people.
Let me keep going. Why are you getting that?
I think my friend...
Okay, let's do scripture. All right, well, we out here, you know. Like I said, we on YouTube. If you want to really listen to the truth, just hit up truth. It'll come up.
Kings of the earth.
You know, it'll come up. Where you from anyway? Ethiopia?
Yeah.
Yeah. You don't seem like you have the same Ethiopian spirit, though. Because a lot of our people are missed amongst those Ethiopians that are actually Israelites. They are living amongst those Ethiopian people.
That's why they are calling themselves Christians in Ethiopia.
Right. That are Israelites over there, you know? We're scattered amongst all the nations on the earth.
Haile Selassie ain't no Israelite, though.
Right. Straight up heathen. All right, see you later.
Yeah, you got... They know we don't fuck with that hell. Hey, let me read the rest of this. At Malachi 4:2, I'm going to read 4:1 again. Malachi 4:1, for behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven, and all the proud, yea, and all that do wickedly shall be stubble. And the day that cometh shall burn them up, saith the Lord of hosts.
Future of America.
That it shall leave them neither root nor branch.
Yeah, that's the future of this proud ass nation of America, you know?
But unto you that fear my name, that fear, what's the Lord's name? Yahweh Baha'Sham, Yahweh Shah. But unto you that fear my name, shall the Son of Righteousness arise with healing in his wings, and you shall go forth and grow up as calves in the stall. But this is the point right here. And ye shall tread down the wicked, for they shall be ashes under the soles of your feet in the day that I shall do this, saith the Lord of hosts. This Lord of hosts means Lord of the army. So the Lord said these people gonna be ashes. The Bible said that the wicked, all you wicked and adulterous fools out here, you're gonna be turned into a pile of ashes.
That's right. Thermonuclear heat is gonna do it.
That'll turn your ass to ashes real quick.
That's right. It's gonna evaporate these fools. This is 2 Peter 3. Oh, let me, so I'm just gonna start at 7. 3 and 7. 2 Peter 3 and 7. But the heavens and the earth, which are now, by the same word, are kept in store reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men.
Yeah, America's a nation of ungodly men. All the men in America are a bunch of faggots. A bunch of weak, effeminate bitches. That's all you got in America. Half of them are actually homosexuals, bisexuals. You know what I'm saying? They engage in scat sex and bestiality. You got pedophiles.
The American way. Goddamn American way. There go that goddamn again. That's going to offend some people. Goddamn devil. But beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing, that one day is with the Lord as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat.
Yeah, so America's gonna get melted. The Most High God of the universe, he's gonna melt America. And all you adulterers and wicked ass people right up in it with it. Y'all gonna get melted. If you ain't right with the Most High, you're gonna get melted. You're gonna get turned into a pile of ashes. You're gonna be disintegrated. Okay? You're gonna eat missiles.
Yeah, right.
You know,
we don't have that missile picture.
Oh, man. What missile picture? Man, I need a good missile picture.
Man.
The Most High ain't fucking with you people. He's going to destroy you. He's going to destroy your family. He's going to destroy your pets, your dogs.
All their valuable possessions.
Yeah, all your gold, your silver, your Federal Reserve notes is all going to be destroyed.
But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, boom, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat, and the earth also, and the works that are therein shall be burned up.
Yeah, because you people are in America, y'all live in a fucking la-la land, okay? Like, y'all in fucking outer space, all right? You have no fucking clue what's going on in the world. Here's a Russia about to shoot missiles on your ass, and you walking around in a damn dreamlike state. Everybody's high on pills. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, a study came out of the news that said 80% of Americans are hooked on pain pills. Whew. Bunch of goddamn drug addicts. A bunch of drug addicts. According to the CDC, over 50% of Americans have STDs. So every other woman you meet got genital warts, herpes. A bunch of damn hoes and bitches. Sluts. Prostitutes. Whores.
See?
That's a fact. These are government statistics.
Yeah,
and that's the only what's been recorded. That's only the reported cases. Because a lot of you hoes, you won't even go to the clinic to clean your shit. Your shit just gets worse and worse. Now that's why they got antibiotic resistant forms of gonorrhea floating around. And you can't even treat it. Antibiotics don't even work no more. The reason they don't work is all you people keep going to the clinic for your gonorrhea, your clap, syphilis.
Abusing that shit, huh?
You're abusing the antibiotics, now they don't work no more. Because you're a bunch of filthy faggots and heathens and whores and bitches.
See then, that all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of persons ought ye to be in all holy conversation and godliness?
Yeah. They ain't got no godliness about them.
Looking for and hasting unto the coming of the day of the Most High,
like a jack.
You got sneakers.
We're in the heavens. I hate you,
I know. She was making faces at us.
Looking for and hasting unto the coming of the day of the Most High. We're in the heavens, being on fire.
So the heavens are going to be on fire. What does it mean for the heavens to be on fire? The heavens talking about the sky. That fire is talking about those thermonuclear missiles. That's what you got coming. You got a, soon there's going to be a thermonuclear war. All right? And the majority of people ain't going to make it. You're going to die.
This is true. I can't.
Looking for and hasting unto the coming of the day of the Most High, wherein the heavens being on fire shall be dissolved, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat.
Get that sign on camera over there that motherfucker's holding. Zoom in on it. Not a zoom.
Nah.
Pull that little trigger up top. That thing on top. See what that sign says.
Hey.
You gotta pull it back. No, not that one.
Oh, wait, sorry.
I'm just curious. I'll go ahead, get Isaiah 66:15.
Is it that's what I was thinking about too.
Oh, here, fuck, I don't want to see that shit. Hey, just hold that here. Don't hit none of them buttons. You might hit the wrong button. Right. Does it still say record?
Yeah.
All right, we're good.
Okay, before now, man, what's up with you? One of the codes,
I get it. Isaiah 58
or 57.
Here,
I got it. It's 54.
Oh, 54, yeah. I knew it was 50-something. I didn't get anything. I mean, kids just showing their titties and shit.
Dang, what did you fucking look at?
Man, I was at the thrift store today, and I got the bitches wearing them little ass shirts. I'm like standing behind her line, seeing her nipples and everything, just staring at her.
Wow.
You know, I'm just saying, these bitches walk around half damn naked. Like, I'm not gonna look at your titties, right. Bitch.
Shit, ain't nobody around here no fucking fact, so, you know.
Shit, I want to grab them titties, you know what I'm right. saying? When you see him out there like that, he just want to, like, what's up, baby? Just grab them titties, start squeezing them.
You know, humble that
put one in my mouth, you know what I'm saying?
That's right.
I'm just saying, what are you supposed to do? When a bitch is walking around with the titties popping out, what are you supposed to do?
Let me tell you something. These people act like, these women act like they're offended by our talk, but they're not. You know, that's one thing they like is an aggressive man that's speaking his mind. They act like that's wrong. They act like they ain't thing with how they, you know, how they want to hear it. But, you know, these some deceitful ass bitches, man.
Dang.
That's exactly how they want it. They want a man to snatch them up, you know?
That's why there's laws in the Bible that say we can snatch them up.
That's right. That's right. Here you go. That says Isaiah 4:54-16. Behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire.
Yeah, smith. The modern day smith is talking about a rocket scientist. You know what I'm saying? An engineer.
That's right.
Go ahead.
Modern day. Behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire, and that bringeth forth an instrument for his work.
Smith. They gonna get blown to smithereens. Get smith? That's like that.
That's right.
Hey, but rare, look.
Smithereens.
Yeah, but look, to get blown to smithereens, remember we was talking about this? Do you know what the word smithereens means? You don't know that.
No.
The word smithereens comes from a lieutenant that fought for the Confederacy in the Civil War. And there was a famous battle of York, I believe. But his last name was Smithers. His last name was Smithers. His ass got hit by a cannonball. And they said he got exploded into a billion pieces. So that's what it means to get blown to smithereens. You're going to get done just like old Smithers. That's where the Lord going to blow you fools to smithereens.
That's right, that's right. Behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire, and that bringeth forth an instrument for his work, and I have created the waster to destroy.
The waster, now waster, is those thermonuclear missiles, those missiles. You know what a missile silo is? Okay, y'all ever heard of a missile? Have you ever heard of nuclear warfare? Have you ever heard of a nuclear submarine? Have you ever heard of a fucking stealth bomber? Okay. That's a good.
This is all real, man.
That shit don't exist.
Right. It's all sci-fi. Yeah. It's all sci-fi movies. And that's what's been instilled in these people's mind, that all that shit is just sci-fi movies, man. When you go to the movie come out,
get that,
you pay $20 for one goddamn ticket.
Is that Scooby? That ain't as big as a damn horse.
All right. You know you're having sex with him.
Oh, man. You know if you having sex with that dog?
Better not be having sex with that fucking dog.
It probably was. There's a lot of bestiality out here. You know what I'm saying?
A lot.
There's a bunch of fucking weirdos out here, man. The person your next door neighbor who's all nice and polite to you all the time, he's in there raping his dog. You know what I'm saying?
That's right. These women love having little dogs.
Yep.
That licks them.
They licks them all day. Wow. They got videos all over the internet documented and testifying to the fact.
And you see the women smiling in the videos too, like they're having a good time.
That's the top selling videos probably.
Yep, it is.
As you hear people getting caught with all kind of sick shit. People getting caught with giant collections of porn on their computers.
Child porn
and snuff films. Now not only do they like child porn, they like to watch little kids get killed on camera. Wow. You know what I'm saying?
How you gonna concentrate on these asses fucking
up? I know, these bitches need to put some clothes on. You can't even think straight with a bunch of half-naked hoes and bitches walking down the street. You know what I'm saying? That's why the Lord called these hoes a wicked and adulterous generation.
Look at them old films back in the 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s.
Yeah, you ain't seen, what's that bitch's name, to play Wizard of Oz, Judy Garland?
Yeah.
You ain't never seen Judy Garland's titties. Never in no movie.
She always had a dress on, right?
Always had a dress on. You know what I'm saying?
Always.
Not these hoes these days.
Mm-mm.
You know what I'm saying?
What's that popular shit they wear now, those black tight things?
You can see their pussy.
Leggings. Leggings.
But they're like some aerobic gear, though. That's what they're
looking for. You can see everything. You can leave nothing to the imagination.
Oh, something wrong with that saying something, though.
Yeah. Like that scripture he read earlier. You're supposed to say something. Just like when you see a damn Muslim walking down the street. You're supposed to say something to that motherfucker. What the fuck you doing walking down the street? You know what I mean?
Heathen shit.
Well, yeah, walk around with your heathen shit. Walk around talking about Muhammad and all that bullshit.